Senator, the housing downturn and the mortgage meltdown has created a confidence situation in America. There's a crisis in confidence. There's an economic crisis. There's a lot of uncertainty out there. You know it. I know it. You're hearing from the people of Connecticut, many of whom are living paycheck to paycheck at this point. And part of the confidence problem we have in this country is that people see powerful politicians like yourself, chairman of a very powerful committee, the Senate Banks Committee, receiving special treatment from Countrywide. And I know there's a Senate Ethics Committee, but look, the truth be told, you know it's a joke. I know it's a joke. The rules of evidence don't apply. It's not a court of law. It's the club, an equal number of Democrats, an equal number of Republicans. I don't know what their final letter is going to be, because they'll issue a letter, and you know what the options are. It can be anything from a reprimand to, in the case of a criminal matter, expulsion from the Congress. In the case of your late dad, who I have a lot of respect for, by the way, he was censured in part by using campaign funds to pay his mortgage. And I find the connection here quite interesting. Why don't you simply release the mortgage application that you and your wife signed? And why don't you simply release the HUD statement that you and your wife signed?
Well, first of all, you drew a lot of conclusions there, I might add.
Well, Senator, only because you have been unwilling to answer the questions.
No, I'm answering the questions. You know, I may not like the answers, but I mean, I'm very candid with you. You draw a conclusion about getting favorable treatment. I'll say it again to you. I never sought, never received, never aware of any special treatment. The rates we were given are available, standard market rates. They were given for adjustable rate mortgages and refinancing that summer of 2003. And that's all out there in the public domain.
Well, Senator, Senator, the mortgage application and the HUD statement, that's real easy. It's probably sitting in a file cabinet somewhere in your home office. Why don't you just release it?
Well, fine. Hey, look, the point is here, there's an investigation going on. Let me finish, first of all. And secondly, on this matter, the issue is whether or not, did you seek or were you offered any special treatment? And the answer to that is categorically no. The only person we ever dealt with, we went back and examined records for more than 20 years. Did we ever receive a phone call, any correspondence from these people? Never one. Not one.
But, Senator, directly to my point, the HUD statement and the mortgage application, why aren't you going to release that, or are you going to release
that? We will at some point. But the reason is that, obviously, there's an investigation going on. I'd hope to be over by now. It started in June. It was public information. When it started, we welcomed it. We've turned over all the information to it, and that's where it is at this point.
But, Senator, now you're referring to the Senate Ethics Committee. Which all credible objective analysis indicates that's a paper tiger. That's not a court of law. In other words, there's nothing to restrain you from releasing this information in advance of a report from the committee, is there?
What do you mean it's not a court of law? You've already drawn the conclusion no matter what they say.
No, Senator, I'm talking about the process. I understand the process as well as I think you do.
You've asked me the question, and my answer to you is that when this process is complete, where it is, where all the information has been made available, all the questions have been responded to, let them complete their work. I'd hope it would be completed by now. And after that, we'll release documents that people need to see. But in the meantime, it's a lot more involved than that, than just, you know, a couple of documents you're looking for here.
Well, Senator, I've asserted here on this show that I think you actually committed mortgage fraud. Okay, now prove me wrong. All right, release the HUD statement, release the mortgage application. There's nothing in the Senate Ethics Commission that restrains you from releasing this information. There's no procedure here that would prevent you from releasing that information.
Well, you've already drawn the conclusion, so I don't know what you need the information.
Well, then prove me wrong.
Okay,
release the information.
At some point, we will. What's your other question?
Well, all right. Well, the last question that I have, because I know we're running out of time here. The last question.
The final question is on the bailout, Senator. A lot of that money is being used by beneficiaries to buy other banks and buy other lenders, which I know really wasn't the intent. How do you respond to that?
Well, I think two things. First of all, it ought to be used only for lending purposes, and that was. While it wasn't specifically stated, in fact, we left that open because, in fact, we initially passed the bill. What the Treasury wanted to do was to engage in the auction process, which is buying the distressed instruments rather than buying equity positions in these institutions. I don't have, if they're using the money on occasion to buy a failing bank, then that's one fact situation that could, in fact, be warranted. If it's a healthy institution buying another healthy institution, that's totally unwarranted in my view.
Mm-hmm.
And certainly giving dividends to shareholders is unwarranted in my view with public money.
But was it anticipated that they would use this money to buy other institutions?
No, it was not. And in fact, there was little or no anticipation. In fact, even where Treasury was, they didn't even engage in investing or taking equity positions in these institutions. As you may recall, all that Hank Paulson wanted to do with it is buying the distressed instruments in these institutions, which is very different, obviously, than providing direct equity to them. Now they've shifted, I think primarily because Gordon Brown, the Prime Minister of Great Britain, decided to move in that direction and saw some very positive results in the flow of credit, the easing of the credit market to capital markets.
Is your committee going to provide some oversight and some hearings to try to rein these people in who are spending the money to buy institutions?
Yeah, we have a hearing, I think, in about 10 days with the banks coming in themselves. We had one last week. We've got some informal hearings tomorrow and the next day on the subject matter as well, looking at it, and clearly going to have the banks in to determine. I've said publicly when I've been asked about it, that if they engage in practices such as mergers and acquisitions or dividend payments, then they'll, quote myself, and probably a little stronger language than I could have used, they'll be held to pay.
Okay, Senator, appreciate you checking in. Appreciate it.
No, thank you for your time as well.